Hey, everybody. I am coming to you a little bit late with last week's fundraiser fitness video. So last week was supposed to be filmed, but I did not. So I'll go ahead and do that now. Our video is going to be a HIIT workout, I Heart HIIT, I'll call it, because it's a little bit Valentine's Day themed. We have some Valentine's love themed songs. So I'll go ahead and start our playlist up. I'm going to link the playlist in the description, as well as all the moves we're doing for our HIIT workout. So this workout is a little bit different than some of our other workouts. It's mostly going to be, it'll be more like cardio incorporated moves. So you're going to actually need a pair of shoes to wear for this. And then I also have like a towel or mat for some of the core exercises. So it's going to incorporate strength, but it's also going to be a little bit of cardio. So I'm going to go ahead and put my shoes on here. Alrighty. All right, and shoes are just to give yourself a little bit of support. Some of these moves will have a jumping component. You can get rid of the jumping component. I'm not gonna do the jump just because I have neighbors below me and our floors are pretty thin. So I'll take out the jump. All right, so the workout we're doing officially today is called HIIT. HIIT stands for High Intensity Interval Training. So like I said, there's gonna be strength in these movements, but it's also going to be a lot of cardio. So most of these moves are gonna be, I think, 40 seconds on, 10 seconds off. So you can kind of follow along with my timing, or you can look at the description and time the moves yourself. Alrighty, let's go ahead and get started. Let's see. Okay. Give me 1 second. Okay, sorry about that. All right, I've got our little schedule here. We're gonna start out with a warm-up. So we're gonna start out with basic jacks here. I've got my towel on the ground, so I'm just gonna kind of move that over. I'm also wearing my charity shirt here, 261 Fearless, came in the mail. I love it. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started with those jacks. So feel free to add the jump if you want here. I'm just going to walk it out. I'm keeping my core engaged, arms and legs. Arms coming up and then back down, legs are going side to side. Nice job. Keeping your arms nice and strong here, core nice and strong. I'm hitting the wall a little bit. All right, just warming up here, breathing. Let's take four more here. And one, nice job, kind of jog it out here. All right, we're gonna move into some basic side steps. So you can kind of sink low a little bit. You'll feel this in your glutes and thighs. Feel free to add that jump. Once again, I'm just gonna do the modification here. And I'll tilt this down just so you can kind of see what I'm doing. That jump is gonna look like this. So adding a little hop there. Otherwise, just tapping side to side, staying low. Nice job. Getting your heart rate up a little bit here, engaging your muscles. Let's take four more on each side here. All right, nice job. All right, got a couple more moves here for our warm-up. We're gonna move into high knees. So same thing for this guy. Feel free to add that jump. I'm gonna start out just by engaging my core, bringing my knee up as high as I can. Once again, add the jump if you want. You don't have downstairs neighbors. But you know, even without this jump here, you're getting those muscles engaged, getting a little bit of cardio in as you pick up the pace here. Nice job. Hopefully you're able to hear the music here. So 261 is actually the bib number of the first woman to run the Boston Marathon. And I feel like I've explained her story in some of my other videos, but I'll go ahead and explain it again. Her name is Catherine Switzer. So in 1967, she tried to run the Boston Marathon and succeeded. But during the race, someone attacked her. Someone in the crowd attacked her for being a woman and actually tried to rip off her bib. But she kept running and she finished. And so she started this organization called 261 Fearless to empower women to run. The organization leads clubs all over the country and in other countries to get women to feel empowered to run, regardless of their financial status, location, all aspects of background and identity. All right, let's take four more on each side here. Nice job. All right, so we'll go ahead and move into our circuits here. So these moves, like I said before, are gonna be 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off. We're going to start out with a little bit of glutes and thighs. So our circuit is gonna be a plank circuit. So it's gonna incorporate a little bit of cardio. But we're also gonna be getting some strength from working those glutes and thighs. So that's our first circuit. We have two more circuits after that. We have a plank circuit. Once again, gonna be strengthening core here and as well as chest, arms. So we'll be incorporating some cardio into those plank moves as well. Our last circuit is a core circuit, a little bit of cardio and especially strength for your abdominal muscles. So these are the three circuits. You can feel free to do these a second time through. So go through all three, do it a second time. I'm just gonna show you the three circuits and then stop there, but feel free to create your own workout with the circuits. You can go through the circuits multiple times. Do what feels best for you. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started with this squat circuit first. So we've got about four different squat moves. We are going to start out with a sidestep squat. So I'm gonna tilt the screen down a little bit here. This is a little bit similar to, I'll go ahead and get rid of this towel. This is a little bit similar to the move we started out with our warm-up. We're gonna sink our hips down low, butt is back. So try to keep those knees just right above the ankles here. we're going to step from side to side. So and this is a little bit different from the side step, just because as we're stepping side, we're squatting down low. So side step, squat a little bit lower. Feel free to add a jump here and then squat. Nice job. So I'm gonna go ahead and start that timer. Staying low, you should feel this in your glutes and in your thighs. Keep breathing here. Breathing is super important. Staying low, we've got 10 seconds left here. Keep breathing. Inhale as you kind of come up and move into that step, and then exhale, lowering into that squat. And go ahead and stop. Nice job. All right, we're gonna take 20 seconds here. We're gonna move into our next move, which is our squat jump. Once again, I'm gonna get rid of that jump. Feel free to use it. And we'll go ahead and get started now. All right, so. Sorry, the screen's a little bit weird. We're gonna squat down, jump up. I'm just gonna do basic squats here. Feel free to use that jump. So squatting low. When you squat, think about setting those hips all the way back. And then as you come up, engaging your core. If you are getting rid of that jump, make sure to be intentional about how you're coming up, engaging that core, straightening out your spine here. So I am inhaling as I come up, exhaling, lower down. Nice job. Let's take 5 more seconds here. And go ahead and come all the way up. Nice job. All right, we are moving into a squat with a kick. So once you get the squat down, these moves are kind of nice just because you're adding a little bit more. So this is a basic squat. Then as you come up, you are kicking forward. So flexing that foot, inhale, squat, exhale, coming into that kick. Engage your core as that leg comes up. Try not to wobble here. Keep your balance. Nice job. May actually start that timer. Sorry about that. Kick forward, lower down. Nice job. Use your breath here. Allows you to keep going, allows you to get oxygen into your muscles. So hopefully other people are enjoying these videos. It's been a little bit of low turnout for the actual live fitness videos. But hopefully people are able to look back at these and use them. All right, go ahead and stop here. Nice job. We're gonna go ahead and move into our lunges. For these, you can add a jump if you like. We're gonna go ahead and get started. So I'll show you these moves here. I'm lowering down into that lunge. Knee is right above the ankle as I come forward. And then I'm coming back up. So inhale, lift, exhale, lower down. You should feel this in that glute and thigh. Use your breath. Open up through your chest here. You're getting a lot of breath in here just because you're like continuing to move. There's not really any break between each move here. So working that quarter, that cardio, can't talk, and also getting that heart rate up. Okay, nice job. All right, so that was your squat circuit. So we had our sidestep squat. We had our squat jump. We had our squat with the front kick, and we had our squat lunge. So feel free to go through that circuit again if you'd like. Otherwise, we're gonna hop into the next circuit for our plank. So I'm gonna go ahead and lower you down here. So this plank series is nice because it's a little bit of full body strength. Plank works upper body, it works core. You really need all of your muscle groups engaged in that plank position. We're also gonna use a little bit of cardio in these plank moves, kind of moving back and forth quickly. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. For this circuit, you're gonna need a mat or towel. I'm trying to think, sometimes the towel is a little bit difficult because you don't have as much grip. So if you don't have a mat, it might be easier just to go on the hard ground here. If it feels good, you can put a towel just underneath your hands to give your wrists a little bit of support. Do whatever works best for you. All right, so first move is just our basic plank. We're gonna find our plank form and just work on engaging our breath in that plank position. Okay, so I'm gonna move my towel away just because I think it'll be a little bit more challenging for me. I am gonna put my wrists underneath the towel here just so I have a little bit more support. Okay, so for this plank position, shoulders are right above the wrists. We can kind of start in our tabletop position. So knees are right underneath the hips. We're gonna extend our legs out long here. Back is flat, butt is down low. So this is the plank position. And I'm just breathing here. Nice deep breaths. Try to think about your spine extending in one nice long line. So your neck should be in line with your spine here. And just breathing. Forgot to start that timer. So hopefully you have, maybe you have a timer going on. Sorry, sometimes these videos are a little haphazard. So just keep breathing here. Deep inhale, filling up with air, exhale, releasing, staying strong here. Modification here, feel free to come onto your knees, still keeping that butt low, back flat. We've got 10 seconds here. And go ahead and lower all the way down, nice job. All right, awesome. Okay, so that was our basic plank move. We're going to go ahead and move into our next plank, which is gonna be our climbers. So for this move, you can take this at any pace that feels comfortable. You can totally speed this up or slow it down. So I'm gonna go ahead and move into the climber. Same thing as before, feel free to use the towel to support your wrist here. If you have a mat, that might feel more comfortable. And let's go ahead and start. I'll start that timer this time. All right, so we're gonna come into that plank position and knee is just gonna come in. If you wanna speed this up, you can. I'm gonna try to be graceful about this just because my neighbors are pretty sensitive to the noise. So knee comes in, still keeping that butt low. and breathing here. Nice job. Feel free to come into that modified plank if you need. We've got 10 seconds left here. And go ahead and lower those knees. Nice job. All right, we've got a couple more moves left in our plank position. So our next move is gonna be our plank jack. So this is gonna have a jump component to it. You can always take out the jump. All right, so we're coming back into that plank position. All right, look at that. All right, this is kind of a, you can probably tell I'm a little bit all over the place. I'm filming this on a Monday morning. So I have class later, but I've got this time free for the most part. All right, so we're moving into those plank jacks. So plank position, I'm gonna walk each foot out to the side here. If you want to move into the jump, you're taking both legs out and adding that hop. I'm just gonna move from side to side here. So I've got that timer on, no worries. And breathe here. You can also take this into modified plank, just moving those knees back and forth. And when you're ready, go ahead and lower all the way down. Nice job. All right. I think we have one more move in this position. So we're gonna end with a bang for this circuit. We have our burpee, which you might have heard of before. This is an awesome move because it incorporates strength and also a lot of cardio. I'm gonna do the modified version of this again. So move is gonna look something like this. Let me bring you up here. So it's going to be a combination of that plank position and then also a jump. So we're starting by reaching our hands up at the jump if you want. Then we're gonna come down into that plank position, both feet are coming up, and then reach back up again. If you wanna add that jump, feel free. With that jump, you're gonna jump at the top. As you come down, legs are gonna come out into that plank, and then both feet are gonna come up toward your hands into a jump, and then you're gonna continue that jump at the top. So feel free to do this the modified way or with the jump. All right, I'm gonna keep the screen here. You're gonna see me pop up, I guess. Okay. Let's go ahead and start the timer. Okay. Reaching hands up and then coming into that plank position. Even with the modification here, feel free to make the most out of this move by being intentional about engaging your muscles. So I'm reaching my hands to the top. I'm coming into that plank, making sure I have the right form. Legs are coming up. Still engaging the whole time here. We've got 5 seconds left. And nice job. All right. Awesome job. We are done with our second circuit. So we had our basic plank. We had our climbers. We had our plank jacks, and then we finished off with some burpees. So feel free, once again, go through the circuit again. We're going to move into our last circuit for the HIIT workout. This is our core circuit. So we actually have three moves for this circuit. So this is the part where a mat especially will be helpful, and a towel will even work for this part, just so that you have a little bit of support for your lower back when you're laying down. All right, so I'm going to bring you down here. Alrighty. And you might even want to double up with that towel just so you have a little bit more support. All right. We're going to go ahead and get started. So come on to your back here. I'll lean me down so you can see me. We're going to start out with just our basic curls. So I'm going to start that timer. And think about lifting through your chest here. Hands are going to come behind your head, and then coming up and lowering down. So I'm exhaling to lift, inhale to lower. With this move, it's really easy to think about pulling up with your neck. We don't want to do that. So think about engaging your core, lifting through your chest. You shouldn't feel any pain in your neck here. And keep breathing. Nice job. Awesome job. All right, 5 seconds here. And go ahead and lower all the way down. Nice job. All right, we're gonna move into our second move here. Our bicycle crunches. So this is going to incorporate a little bit of cardio here. I'm going to go ahead and start that timer. All right, so right knee is going to come in toward the chest. You're going to extend that other leg long. We're going to lift up to the chest here and then switch back and forth. We're going to spread our elbows wide now and then bring opposite elbow toward knee. So keep breathing here. You can slow this down, just being intentional. And if you like, you can take up this pace a little bit more here. Nice job. Keep breathing here. Oop, looks like our timer froze. We've got 20 seconds left here. So already I'm feeling this might be hurting my back a little bit. So if you need, feel free to put another towel over the towel that you already have. That's 2 seconds left. And lower all the way down. Nice job. Awesome job. I know these circuits can be a lot right after one after another. So feel free to grab water in between these. I'm gonna go ahead and move into our last move. So this is our last move of our last circuit. These are our scissor kicks. A little bit of cardio, a little bit of core. All right. So coming down here, it's always a little bit difficult to figure out the angle so you can see. I'm gonna tilt this guy up just so you can see my legs moving back and forth. So I'm gonna extend one leg long here. It's okay if there's a slight bend in your knee. We're gonna keep that core engaged and we're just moving back and forth like scissors. I'm staying lifted through my chest to engage my core here. If you need, feel free to lower down and place your hands underneath your tailbone to protect your lower back a little bit more. Figure out what feels best for you. I'm starting that timer now. So keep breathing here. You can take the pace up, or you can slow it down. We are about halfway through here with this move. We've got 10 seconds left. And 2 seconds here. All right, go ahead and hug your knees in. Awesome job. All right, awesome job, everybody. Hopefully you enjoyed this. Hopefully this was helpful to somebody. Once again, feel free to use these circuits like in a combination. So you could add, like you could do 2 of the plank circuits, do 2 of the glute, 2 of the core, or you could go through all 3 of them and then do that one more time. So you can kind of customize this to make it what you want. All right, so we're gonna do a little bit of cool down before we finish up today. All right. So I'm actually just gonna finish this off with the warm up that we started with. Instead of accelerating our heart rate, hopefully this will just slow down our heart rate. So just focus on your breathing here, moving into those jacks. I am modifying this to take out the jump. Feel free to add the jump if you would like. Either way, you should be slowing down your breath here. Deep inhale and exhale. Nice job. Breathing here. Alrighty. Let's take 4 more here. We're gonna move into those side steps. Just moving back and forth here. Feel free to move those arms back and forth. Open up your chest a little bit. Nice job. All right, we're gonna finish off with those high knees. And then we'll do a little bit of stretching here. My shoulder's popping a little bit here. All right, let's take 4 more on each side. Finding your breath here. Nice job. All right, let's go ahead and move into some stretches. So I'm just gonna bring 1 leg forward here. Knee is just above the ankle, extending that back leg. You should feel this in your quad of that leg that's extended. You should also feel this in your calf of that leg that's extended. Nice job. Just breathe here and then switching sides. Opening up, breathing. Hopefully you've liked this music. They're all kind of subtle Valentine's Day songs, but all have like a love message. All right, we're gonna go ahead and flex 1 foot here, slight bend in the other leg, and then we're just leaning forward. However far forward you can come is totally fine. You should feel this in your calf. And then when you're ready, switching sides. Deep breaths here. We're gonna come up I'm going to hug my foot into my glute here. Should feel this in your quad. Nice job. So you're getting a nice view from my apartment just on the outskirts of Boston. We had a little bit of snow this morning. We've actually been having more snow than we have had the last couple of years. All right, switching sides. And then stretching out our thighs here, we're gonna bend that one knee, extend the other, just side lunge here. Feel free to lift that arm up as well, stretching out that chest, back. And then switching sides when you're ready. Nice job. For this stretch, next stretch, you might need to hold on to something. We're gonna place, bend our right leg, place our ankle just above our left knee, and then we're sinking our hips back. So you should feel this in your glute and thigh of the leg that's bent. Hopefully you can see that okay. And then switching sides when you're ready. Stretch out our glutes from our plank series. We're gonna take one last stretch here, leaning all the way down to your toes, dropping your head, slight bend in your knees is totally fine. Finding your breath. And then when you're ready, slowly rolling up one vertebrae at a time, rolling those shoulders back, rolling out that neck. Thank you so, so much. Sorry again, that this was a little bit discombobulated, but hopefully you enjoyed that. Once again, feel free to change this however you like. And thank you so much for supporting me. I'm gonna leave my donation link in the description box in case you're interested in helping me get closer to my goal for 261 Fearless. Thank you so much again, and would love to see you this Thursday for our next workout. Bye.